Greetings, everyone. Today, I will introduce you two upcoming major events in the AI world.
Additionally, I will be demonstrating a demo of my upcoming voice cloning tutorial, where I will have the AI read the entire epilogue generated by the new Longgboi model.
The first one is a large language model trained with 64K plus context length. This model is announced by Naveen Rao, who is CEO of MosaicML. MosaicML has composer PyTorch library for efficient neural network training, so these guys are already experts in the field. When we ask the ChatGPT free edition what is its context length, the answer is only 2K tokens. With 64K token length, you can generate 32 times bigger coherent and consistent text than ChatGPT. If you wonder what is context size, context size refers to the maximum number of tokens or words that a language model can take into consideration when generating text or making predictions. In other words, it is the amount of text that the model can use as input to make a decision or generate a response. The context size of a language model can have significant impact on its performance and accuracy. A larger context size allows the model to take into account more information when making predictions, which can lead to more accurate results. With 64K context length, you can input an entire project and ask it to refactor or upload an entire document and ask any questions about it. This can dramatically improve basically anything regarding analysis of text, data, and programming. The name of the announced model is Longgboi, and it will be open sourced at the end of this week. Once it is released, hopefully I will make a tutorial for how to use it. And the second big upcoming thing is ChatGPT with Code Interpreter. Code Interpreter feature of ChatGPT is still in alpha mode and only available to those who are selected for alpha testing. So it is not public yet. Code Interpreter is GPT-4 with three new capabilities. The AI can read files you upload up to 100 megabytes, which is huge. It can let you download files, and it lets the AI run its own Python code. Now, this is significant. With Code Interpreter, the ChatGPT, the GPT-4, will be able to run its own Python code. This is amazing. So here, an example of Python code execution. The input is like this. I am writing a blog post about how amazing ChatGPT is at working with code right now. I would like you to create the perfect illustration, a GIF using Python that represents this ability. Decide what an appropriate, amazing GIF would be, then figure out how to create it and let me download it. So the ChatGPT with Code Interpreter is writing this code, and then it is generating this GIF image you are seeing right now and letting others to download it. It is just amazing. But this is not all. The first question author asked is, show me something numinous using Python. And the ChatGPT with Code Interpreter is saying this, let's use Python to create a visualization of Mandel's broad set, which may evoke a sense of awe and wonder. And this is the output. This is just significant. This is huge. And here another use case. The author uploads an Excel file without providing any context and asks three questions. Can you do visualization and descriptive analysis to help me understand the data? This is huge. This is significant. Can you try regressions and look for patterns? Can you run regression diagnostics? These are the fields that requires expertise, and now with GPT-4 and Code Interpreter, you won't need expert people for this. The model will be able to provide you these informations. I will put the link of this page into description so you can check it out if you are interested in more details. And now another major thing that GPT-4 with Code Interpreter. The author uploads 60 megabyte US Census dataset and asks the AI to explore the data, generate its own hypothesis based on the data, conduct hypothesis tests, and write a paper based on its results. This requires huge expertise, huge amount of working time, and other things. However, the model is able to do all of this in several seconds and give you output. You see, It wrote an academic paper about it, and here the abstract of the paper. According to the author, it is not a stunning paper yet. Of course, we are not expecting it, but this is a stunning work of AI model, and it will only get better over time. And another thing is, it does every data visualization that the author can think of. This is amazing. Below, the author shown some of the data visualization graphics, and he didn't even provide data. He said model to generate fake data to just demonstrate these graphs. The GPT-4 will also get plugins and browsers. However, according to the author, they are still not very good. Plugins and browser support is still not public, only in alpha mode and only available to those selected few people. So as a final thing, I will make my cloned voice to read entire tweet of Naveen Rao. Hopefully, I will make a full tutorial about how to train a voice and generate as much as possible natural sounding awesome quality voices for free on your computer with only 6 GB VRAM having GPUs.
Large language model trained with 64,000 plus context length. What could you do with that? Prompted our model with the entire contents of The Great Gatsby and asked it to write the epilogue. Model dropping soon to an open source repo near you. Epilogue. It seemed to me that Gatsby was already dead when I went up to East Egg. He died before I could find out. I thought this as I climbed the old stone steps. They rose up a little now, but were all the same, and the grass had begun to grow in the cracks. On the step, the wind had broken the yellow tape that cordoned them off. I tried to walk over once and had been turned back by a policeman. I had seen something like an exclamation point in the tape when I first looked at it. But when I looked again, I couldn't see it anymore. It had been torn away long ago, no doubt, by a little boy running after his ball. But why should I believe that he was still on the other side, running after his ball? After all the years I would remember this little boy, perhaps it was some cousin or something of that sort. And I would see him running like a young deer across the grass, with the sunrise flashing in his face. It mightn't be that the boy was really there, but the sky might be brighter because the sunlight came in from a different place. The night of Gatsby's burial came as a surprise to me. I had made a point of coming down from my hotel early and driving out to his house in the Ford Roadster, and I had gone over the whole course of that morning in memory. I hadn't expected there would be anything I could actually see on the ground that would show that the old place had once been inhabited. But the moon was full and the white beach had a ghostly sheen. I could have seen the grass growing and the stones standing white and unbroken forever. The cemetery was at the foot of the hill, and when I came down the steep slope, there were white boulders piled up under my feet where they had tumbled away from his grave in the rain. In the rain, Gatsby was buried in a small stone square at the foot of the hill. When I came out on the lawn, there was an open grave. There had been none at first. And standing around was a crowd of people, many of them old acquaintances. I could hear a child weeping and a woman's voice singing in the weeping. A man came forward, I think it was the minister, and offered me his hand. He was a strange-looking man, tall and thin, but I couldn't quite see through his spectacles. "You're a good fellow, Nick, a real good fellow," he said to me. "You know what the minister is gonna say?" I did not know and was surprised. "Mr. Carraway, that was a good boy," he repeated. "He was always good to us." "I am," I said, and I thought of my mother. "Where do you go for minister now?" said the other man, a squat man with a pale beard. He was standing at the grave with his hand on his cane and smiling a little. "I feel bad about all of you," he was saying, "that my boy's gone and left us with so much work. But he's gone, like you said, into the good place. That's where he's at now. That's where he'll stay all the rest of eternity, and we can get together there, all of us." What a thing it was when he first came out here and got so many ideas that he forgot his own family. We had to help that boy see the truth, and now he's seen it. A woman in the crowd was giving a short, passionate wail, almost a howl, over by the grave. "He's gone to another house." The woman stopped. The woman stopped. All the mourners stopped. The minister, who had seen the change in me, said, "There was a time,
you know. There wasn't much chance for him.
But now he's right. It's hard, but you must believe. You know the saying. The young woman began to weep then, and other people took it up. They stood at the grave, looking at one another, talking and crying, and then at a signal from the minister, they began to move off in the moonlight. I went up the hill in the fog, trying to arrange in my mind the order in which I would tell people.
This is all for today. Hopefully more awesome tutorials are coming soon. Please like, subscribe, leave a comment. If you also support us on YouTube by joining or also support us on Patreon, I would appreciate that very much. Please also join our Discord channel. The link of the Discord channel and our Patreon will be in the description of the video and also in the comment section of the video as a pinned comment. Also, I am open to consultation with Stable Diffusion related stuff if you are interested in. Just support us on Patreon and contact me and hopefully I will try to help you privately. Hopefully see you in another amazing video.